a hungry man is a hungry man. The rain a fall, but the dust it up.
That's a great introduction, right? I think at least the dog, you know. But I played this because if we were to do an exposition on Bob Marley, I think it would talk about prosperity and the issues surrounding it. Prosperity is the very essence of the SDGs. It's its raison d'etre. And that's why I'm here today. Prosperity speaks about inclusion. It talks about not leaving anyone behind. It talks about giving people a seat at the table, and it talks about a voice for the voiceless. I'm from a small island developing state. I think you'd have figured out by now which one that is. But during COVID, 100,000 children were unaccounted for in the educational system. Why? Because they couldn't get online. And that speaks to the issues that are so important for so many developing countries. And the truth is, it's not unique to developing countries. Developed countries also had those issues, and the FCC in the United States just announced yesterday programs that they're putting in place for those kids who are unconnected. So digital inclusion is actually a fundamental pillar of the SDGs, of attaining the SDGs. It is the newest and the most democratic driver of development, and it can actually be one of the undergirding elements of driving and fighting for the four that we're speaking about today: decent work, economic growth, infrastructure and innovation, smart cities, habitable cities, and finally, also looking at responsible consumption and production. 2.6 billion to 3.4 billion people are unconnected. That's one third to one half, depending on whose figures you follow. Unconnected in this world that we're talking about. We cannot seriously be talking about development and prosperity where that statistic still exists. For me, connection, digital connectivity, digital access should be a basic service. It should be a fundamental human right. And I say this as somebody who works in international trade. One of the greatest measurements, the most tangible measurements of countries' economic viability is their connectivity. And that showed it really clearly in COVID. If you were connected, you survived. If you were not, you had serious problems. And so for me, digital connectivity, digital inclusion, digital access can solve so many of the fundamental problems and challenges that we face today. It can provide support for smart agriculture, leading to increased yields, increased production, and addressing the issues of food waste and food security, which is such a big problem for us now. It can address the issues of inclusion, financial inclusion for women, for young people, for marginalized groups through fintech. It can also address the issues that are related to decent work and economic growth through e-commerce, through digital facilitation, through all the mechanisms that support and enable trade. And finally, it can even track food wastage, where 930 million tons of food goes to waste every year while millions of people starve. We have a problem. And so let us harness the unlimited, incredible power of digital to create a just society, to create inclusion, and to promote prosperity. I thank you.